Google Photos has an updated Memories tab, and it comes packed with generative AI features. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and today I'm exploring the new updates to Google Photos for 2023, including the new navigation bar, updated memories, and even more AI. It took a little while to roll out, but it's finally here, at least in the US. The Google Photos app may look a little bit different for you now, so let's start with changes to the navigation bar. When you open your Google Photos on iOS or Android, you'll now have a new navigation bar at the bottom. On the left, we've got the Photos tab. Then we've got our Memories tab, which I'm gonna touch more on in just a second. Next up is the Libraries tab. And finally, on the bottom right, we've got our Search tab. But you may also notice changes to the top bar as well. The Google Photos logo is now in the top left rather than the center, and our other icons are grouped neatly in the top right. So here is where you can create a new album now. New album, collage, movie, photo book, or more. And you can pop over to your sharing options as well, or you can tap on your profile icon to see your storage, free up space, or access your photo settings. But let's talk about one of the biggest updates to the Google Photos app, and that's the Memories tab. Obviously, Memories in Google Photos is nothing new, but now they've got a dedicated Memories tab and updates within it. There is now an all-new layout that groups images and videos together into a clickable collage format. It's kind of like a little scrapbook where these groupings are based on events or locations or themes. I've found this new Memories tab more engaging, and I've noticed I do look back on memories a little bit more often now. But there's even more to unpack in Memories. You now have the ability to co-author memories with other users by inviting them to collaborate and add their photos or videos to an album. There are a couple of ways to do this. You can tap on the share icon right underneath the album, or if you've tapped to view the memories in that album, you can share right from there as well. Now, these features are the same on both iOS and Android, though on iOS it says share memory under that album preview with also a share button to the right of that. You can also share the highlights of an album as a video for social media. On both iOS and Android, when you tap on the Memories album, you'll have a little play button on the top right of the first image in that album. You can simply tap on that cover image or on the play button, and here you can use the share option near the bottom right to share highlights. This will save the highlights as a video that you can share with your friends or on social media. But you may have noticed a sneaky new generative AI feature inside my Memories tab. Google Photos is taking a page straight out of Duet AI and adding a similar feature to the Google Photos app. You can now have the Google Photos app generate an album title for you based on the content in that album. So let's try it out. By the way, once again, this is available on iOS and Android. On Android, the prompt is generate title in the top right of the collage grouping. On iOS, it's help me title. So let's try an example from each to see how well it does. On Android, I'll tap on generate title. It's telling me this is an experimental feature, and yes, I would like to see titles. So here are the top three. This really isn't a Halloween album, so the first two it has suggested aren't really that accurate. But then it's got Hanging with My Pup as a title, and that's pretty cute. So I'm gonna tap on that option. And just like that, my Memories album is named for me. So let's test this on iOS for good measure. And this time I will pick this Halloween Memories collage, and I will tap on Help Me Title. And it's nailed the theme for sure. Witchy Night Out, Halloween at Home 2023, Spooky Night with Friends. So these photos were actually taken at my house, so that's scarily accurate. But before I pick something, you can also tap on more ideas for it to generate more if you're not happy with what it's generated. I'm gonna actually pick on Spooky Night with Friends, and there we go. My memory has been titled. How cool is this? So if you don't have this generative AI feature, that's because at least right for now, it's still in its experimental phase. You've gotta be signed up for Google Labs features to get this ability. And I've got a link directly to Google Labs below if you want to try this or other generative AI features from Google. And if you're curious on Duet AI or Google's SGE, their Search Generative Experience, don't worry, I've got you covered. I've linked to those videos for you in the description below. There's seriously so much cool stuff to check out. So those are the new Google Photos updates for 2023. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google Photos updates and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Photos content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.